How are you all? Hope you all are fine and safe at home. Children, today we are going to learn mathematics only. Yesterday in the Zoom class, what we learned? We learned exercise 5.4 and 5.3. 5.4 and 5.3. Today we are going to learn exercise 5.6. It is given in page number 83. Okay, children, we will go into the sums. Okay, first what we are going to see is find the HCF of the following numbers. Find the HCF of the following numbers. HCF means what, children? Highest common factor. Highest common factor. For exam, till exercise 5.7 it will come. Understood, children? Okay, in this today we are going to learn 5.6. HCF means highest common factor. Okay, children, first we will do the first sum. How to find the HCF? How to find the HCF? First sum, we are going to see, we have to find the HCF for 30 and 45. 30 and 45. Okay, see, in the previous sums and all, we wrote the tables like this. But we can't write the tables for every sums, okay, children? So we have to find in 30, in which table and all 30 goes, we have to find out. First, we have to find the prime factors of the prime factors of 30. So first we have to find for 30. In what are the tables it goes? We have to write only the prime numbers. In the yesterday class we learned what are the prime numbers? 3, 5, 7, 13, 11, like that. What are the numbers divisible only by it? Now by the same number, it's prime numbers. So we have to write the prime numbers only. So 30, how it goes? In 2 table it goes. In 3 table also it goes. And in 5 table also it goes. So when you multiply, 30 should come. See, 2 3s are 6. And 6 5s are 30. See, answer 30 came or not, children? 2 3s are 6. 6 5s are 30. These 3 are prime numbers only. These 3 are prime numbers only. Likewise, you have to see for 45. So in 45 also, what will come? It goes in 3 tables. And then again in 3 tables. And then 5 tables. See, 3 3s are 9 and 9 5s are 45. 3 3s are 9, 9 5s are 45. See, these are also prime numbers. 3 3s are 9 and 9 5, 9 into 5, 45. Understood, children? So likewise only you have to find out, the answer should come here. So what are the common factors? See here, common factors is, see, 3 and 5. 3 and 5. So first we have to write to see the common factors. See, common factors are what are the numbers, children? 3 and 5. 3 and 5. So what's the answer, children? We have to find the HCF. See, find the HCF only is there. So the HCF of the HCF, highest common factor of 30 and 45 is what, children? How we have to find? See, 3 and 5 are there. So what you have to write? 3 and 5. 3 and 5 how much? 15. So what's the answer? The highest common factor of 30 and 45 is what? 15. What's the answer? 15. You have to multiply these two common factors. We get 15. Okay, children, we'll move on to the second sum. Okay, children, now see the second sum. Second sum, 15 and 27. 15 and 27. So the prime factors of 15, what will come, children? 3 5s are 15. 3 5. This also prime factor, this also prime factor. 3 5s are 15. Likewise, we have to find out for 27. So 27, how it goes, means, see, 3 into 3 into 3. Because we can't put 9. 9 is not a common prime factor. Okay, children? So 9 3s are 27, we can't put. So only see, 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27. Understood, children? Here 3 5s. Because here 5 is the common prime factor. So I have written 5.
Understood, children? So we have to find out like this only. So common factor is what? 3 only. Common factor is 3. Only 3 is there. Isn't it, children? Common factor is 3. Common factor is 3. Common factor is 3. So what? What's the HCF, children? The HCF also will be the same. The HCF of, we have to write this sentence like this. The HCF of 15 and 27 is 3. Understood, children? Because only one number is common factor. So the highest common factor of 15 and 27 is 3. Okay, children? We'll do the third sum. Okay, children, we see the third sum 20 and 35. We have to use the prime factor numbers as prime numbers and we have to do this sum. So if 20 goes, see, 2 into 2, 2 2's are 4, and then 4 5's are 20, 2 2's are 4, 4 5's are 20. Likewise for 35, see, only 5 into 7 will go. 5 into 7 will go. 5 sevens are 35. It doesn't go in 3 table and all. So 5 sevens are 35. So what is the common factor, children? The only this 5 is the common factor. What is the common factor? Common factor is 5. Common factor is 5. Common factor is 5. So what's the answer, children? The HCF of 20 and 35 is 5. The highest common factor is 5. Okay, children, you have to be thorough in the prime numbers and you have to do this sum. And then what you have to do, 10 sums are there, but I have given only few sums. If you want, what you can do, you can do it in the rough note. You can do all the sums in your rough book at home. So the fourth sum I will give for as a homework. Fourth sum I will give as a homework. Many of them are not doing the homework. Well, I corrected some of them. I gave the homework sum as it is. They didn't do it. Do the sums. Why, I don't know. See, 24 and 96. 24 and 96. This is for your homework, children. This is for your homework. Okay, children. Okay, children, now we move on to the B1. Find the HCF by the prime factorization method. It is also the same like what we saw in the A. Understood that HCF we saw, no? The same method only. Understood? No other change. So I am teaching only 2 sums. Don't think that Mrs. has taught only 2, because the same method only for that also. So first we have to do the prime factors of the prime factors of, first we have to see the 20. So in how we have to use the prime numbers. What are the prime numbers? It goes again 2 2's are 4, 4 5's are 20. Isn't it? We saw the same sums. And then 32. When you multiply this one, this answer should be, we should get. When you multiply this one, if you get this answer only, your answer sum is correct, otherwise it is wrong. Okay, so here we have 32 means what? 2 into 2 4 4 into 2 8 8 into 2 16 16 into 2 32. See, 2 2's are 4 4 2's are 8 8 2's are 16 and 16 2's are 32. So how many 2's are there? 5 2 has come, because okay, what's the common number will come, children? Here 1 2 and here 1 2, isn't it? 2 others you can't put. So what's the answer will come? The HCF of 20 and 32 is 2 into 2, how much, children? 4. So what's the answer? 4. The HCF of 20 and 32 is 4. This is the answer. We have to multiply this number. Understood? 2 into 2. Understood, children? So the sum as it is in the first one only. So only one more sum I will teach, and then we'll go on to the third one. Okay, children? Okay, children, we'll see the second sum, 12 and 36. So, what we have to do? We have to find the prime factors. The prime factors. Of 12. So what are the prime numbers we have to use for 12, children? Easy. 2 into 2. 2 twos are 4. 4. What will come? 4 threes are 12. 2 twos are 4. 4 threes are 12. Otherwise you can put 2 twos are 4. Another 2 also, like this also you can put 2 twos are 4. 4 twos are 8. But it won't come. So you have to write only 3. 2 twos are 4. 4 threes are 12. Okay, children, otherwise you have to, it will be wrong. So next, 36. So 36, what are the prime numbers we have to use? 2 into 2, 4, and then 4 threes are 12, and 12 threes are 36. 12 threes are 36. 2 twos are 4, 4 threes are 12, 12 threes are 36. See, 12 into 3, what will come, children? 36. Okay, children, you have, after writing like this, you have to multiply and you have to check whether this sum is, the answer is coming, 36 is coming or 12 is coming. You have to check it so that it will be easy for you. Okay, children, so what are the common factors, children? See, here also 2, this is common factor, and see, this also 2, and then see here 3. So, 2, 2, 3. Isn't it, children? So, what's the answer? The HCF, highest common factor of 12 and 36 is, see, 2 into 2 into 3. So, what's the answer will come, children? 2 twos are 4, 4 threes are 12. So what's the answer, children? 12. The highest common factor of 12 and 36 is 12. Okay, children, you have to multiply this one. Okay, children, so I didn't give homework for this one because the same sum as it is. So I didn't give homework. But what you can do, you can practice at home. Understood, children? We'll move on to the C. We'll move on to the C sum. Okay, children, now see, you'll see the C1. Find the HCF by the division method. Children, it is little bit hard, but you have to do, you have to practice at home. You have to do in rough note and see, otherwise it's very hard. Children, see, first sum you are going to see 24 and 40. So, see, you have to do this both the sum by division method. Listen carefully, okay, children. The biggest number should be inside the divider, and 24 will be the divisor. Okay, children, see, here 40 will be coming inside. This is dividend, and then 24 is the divisor. So what we can do, we have to divide. Instead of putting the answer quotient above, you have to put in the side. You have to put in this side. So here 40 is there, it, here 24 is there. So 24 ones are 24, and 24 twos are what, children? 48 will come. So can we put 48 here? No. So what will come? 24 ones are 24. 24 ones are 24. So what's the remainder, children? We can't subtract 4 from. So what you have to do? You have to borrow. This will become 10, and this 4 will become 3. So after 4, if you count up to 10, what will come, children? After 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So what's the answer? 6. And then here 3 minus 2, what will come, children? 1. So here 16. Listen all of you carefully. So when it comes 16, what you have to do? You have to make this answer remainder as a divisor. This answer as the divisor. This remainder as the divisor. And what you have to do? You have to put like this. And you have to again here. So when you put the remainder as the divisor, you have to bring this 24 as the dividend. You have to bring this 24 as the dividend. Listen carefully, children. See, this remainder is the divisor, and this divisor became the dividend. This divider became the dividend. So now 16 twos are what will come, children? 16 twos are
6 2s are 12 and 2 1 is 32 will come. So you can't put 32. Can we put 32 children? No. So again what will come? 1. 16 1s are 16. So after 60 can you count? No. So you have to borrow. This will become 14 and this will become 1. After 6 you count up to 14 children. After 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 8. And 1 minus 1, 0 will come. Isn't it? So now again what you have to do children? What I said? This remainder will become what? Divisor. And then what will become the dividend? This 16 will become the dividend. Understood children? This 16 will become the dividend. Now in 8 table 16 goes, isn't it? 8 2s are 16. So 16 minus 16, 0. So what's the answer children? Any guess? No. What's the answer? Which is the divisor? Last divisor is the answer. The last divisor is the answer. Understood children? The HCF of 24 and 40 is 8. Understood children? The last divisor is the answer. Okay children, can you do another sum children? Okay children, we'll see the second sum. See, here also 34, 96. So, what children you have to write inside? The dividend is 96 and the divisor is 34. So, you have to write like this. So, 34 twos are what children? 4 twos are 8, 3 twos are 6. 34 into 3, 3 fours are 12, 102 is coming. So, can we put 102 here? No. So, you have to write 34 twos are 68. So you have to subtract. After this, see, 6 will become 16 and 9 will become 8. So after 8, you, if you count up to 16, what will come children? 8 will come. 8 minus 6, 2. So what's the answer? Remainder 28. So what I said, this remainder will become divisor and this 34 will become dividend. And don't forget children, don't get confused. This will become divisor and this will become dividend. So again automatically what will come? 28 ones are 28. So when we subtract, we can't subtract, isn't it? So what will come? 14 and this 3 will become 2. After 8, if you count up to 14, after 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 6 will come. 2 minus 2, 0. So what will come children again? This will become divisor and what you have to do? This 28 will become dividend. This 28 will become dividend. Now 6 4s are 24. 6 4s are 24. 6 5s are 30 will come. So we can't write. So what will come? 28 minus 24, what will come? The answer remainder is 4. So again what we have to do? This will become the divisor and then 6 will become dividend. 6 will become dividend. So here 4 1 is 4. 4 2s are 8. Can we put 4 2s are 8? No. So 4 1 is 4. So 6 minus 4, what will come children? 2. Now this 2 becomes the divisor and then this 4 will become dividend. So 2 2s are 4. 2 2s are 4. So children, can you know what is the answer children? The last divisor is 2. The last divisor is 2. So what's the answer children? The HCF of 34 and 96 is what children? 2. This is the answer. Understood children? So one more sum, only one more sum I will teach and one I will give for homework. Okay children, you see the last sum, which is the dividend children? 126 is the dividend. The bigger number will be the dividend and the smaller number will be the divisor. So here also what will come? See, 96 twos are, 2 six are 12, 2 nines are 18, 19 will come, isn't it? So you can't write this one. So what you have to write? 1.
96 Don't write 9 here, children. Okay. 6 minus 6, 0. After 9, if you count up to 12, what will come? 10, 11, 12, 3. So, what's the answer? 30. So, what will become, children? This will become divisor and the dividend will be this number, 96. Okay, children. Now, 33s are what? 90. See, 30 into 3s are what? 90 will come. Okay, children. Okay. So, what's the remainder? 6. So, this 6 will become the divisor and this 30 will become dividend. So, in 6 tables, 30 goes. Isn't it, children? 6 5s are 30. So, 30 minus 30, what, children? 0. So, what's the last divisor? 6. So, what's the answer? The HCF of 96 and 126 is what? 6. This is the answer. Okay, children. And I'll give only one sum for homework. The fourth sum I'll give for homework. You have to do only two sums. Only few sums I'm giving. Understood, children? Homework. Homework, fourth sum, 57, 114, 57 and 114. Children, will you do these sums, children? All of you do these sums and kindly send me to the WhatsApp. If you are feeling hard to send in Google Classroom, send it in WhatsApp. Okay, children, we'll meet in the next class. Bye.